A very critical component of the National Weather Service forecasting and warning system is the upper air balloon. Actually, it's called a radio sonde, and here is the instrument. And this instrument, again called a radio sonde, is released twice a day from about 90 National Weather Service offices across the United States. The data from the instrument is sent back in real time. The instrument itself does not store the data. It's sent back in real time to a computer system here at the National Weather Service office, and we plot the data on what's called a skew T log P diagram. It's a vertical profile of the atmosphere on this diagram, and it's the temperature and humidity, pressure and wind that we're plotting. And very critical to weather forecasting is to know, is there a weak storm system passing through at, say, 18 or 20,000 feet? Because if there is, and we're not aware of it, then a forecast for this afternoon might be sunny, when in reality it turns out to be mostly cloudy with rain showers, because possibly we didn't know that system, that weak system, was moving through at 18 or 20,000 feet. This data from the balloon shows us those systems at those levels and helps us to forecast. In addition to that, this is very critical during severe weather, when we're anticipating severe thunderstorms or tornadoes, flash flooding. 3, 4, 5 days in advance of a hurricane making landfall, working with FEMA to let them know where we expect the hurricane to make landfall so that they can pre-position resources and be ready so that when the disaster strikes, they're not then starting to get ready for it. They're already in place, ready to go, and they can immediately move into that area and help the people that are in need. This data 40 years ago with the computer processing we had took us much longer to receive the data back from the balloon release and to analyze it. We used to have to plot this data by hand and then analyze to determine the threat of thunderstorms and tornadoes and flash flooding. Whereas today, it's a matter of minutes when we receive this data back, and we can have that information at our fingertips much more quickly. And it's important in forecasting the weather, again, not what's happening necessarily right now where you are, but what's happening upstream from you, what's coming in the next few days. And so across the world, if we could increase this network and release more of these balloons, that would help in weather forecasting. Without this data, I would say we'd be back in the early 1900s forecasting basically day to day without this information. So it is really a critical component of weather forecasting today.